The unbelievable thing, of course, is that it's full-time, professional development, materials, budget, unprecedented.
It has taken so much stress from my life, and it's also given me such a sense of validation.
When you are presented with an opportunity that is 6 months long and that you know that you're going to be financially stable and that you know you're not working gig to gig, you relax and there's a level of quality that you can actually assert to your work.
This project basically allowed me to really scale up what I do, to grow, and to actually feel that I can take this project to other schools and to devise something that works, you know, within their curriculum, within their personal formats.
I want to make sure that the work that I'm doing with students is relevant and current. Working directly with an industry professional gave us the opportunity to look at what we were doing and compare it to what was happening in the real world.
She wasn't concerned with, you know, curriculum and reports and marks and all the other things that us teachers are constantly trying to juggle. It was just a little bit more pure that we could just sort of focus on art for art's sake.
It's given them meaningful links to integrate curriculum areas, which means that things that they've been learning about in one subject area, to be able to then take that into another subject area and express it in a different way, has really cemented the learning that we're doing.
I think at a lot of schools, arts is undervalued. I think something that a lot of schools learnt when remote learning happened was how valuable it was. I think students realised too.
Well, I think the critical part for our project was that all students were able to tailor what they were creating to their individual interests. Then that got students online. Like, we had some students come to just our subject that didn't turn up to any other subjects for the whole lockdown.
Lockdown has provided people new ways of thinking. You actually look at the things around your house and then thinking, how can I use this to make something else?
I decided to create an animation, never done an animation in my life, of simple drawings, which were their drawings, their words, but I compiled it.
I really had to pare back on what we were going to do. So basically the vision went from this big to this. You know, less is still more, you know, less can be more. And I think that's a really big takeaway for me, especially working in schools, that you don't have to have this big showing.
Having an artist come in on site means that you are creating more extracurricular opportunities, which we know are the things that kids value. On top of that, arts is really diverse. And so unless you have exemplars of what someone's career looks like in the arts, it's very hard for you as a teacher who is teaching the arts to tell students what it is that they can expect from a career in the arts.
These students just don't get that exposure to arts just purely by location. If this program didn't happen, there is the potential that there's a whole cohort of students going through that haven't had any face-to-face interaction with artists. They may never have gone to an art gallery, all of those sorts of things. So that exposure has been fantastic for these students to have that opportunity.